हेलो चिल्ड्रन, विल डू सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ द चैप्टर 7 द वैदिक एज. लास्ट क्लास वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द ब्रह्मवर्त एंड आर्यवर्त. इट इज डिवाइडेड इनटू टू फेज, अर्ली वैदिक पीरियड, लेटर वैदिक पीरियड. अर्ली वैदिक पीरियड विच स्टार्टेड फ्रॉम 1500 BCE टू 2000 BCE एंड दिस रीजन वॉज अंडर द कंट्रोल ऑफ Brahmavarta, which means the land of the god, and they composed the Rig Veda, which is our main source of information about the Brahmavarta. The early Vedic period is also known as the Rig Vedic period. The later Vedic period, which was under the control of Aryans, the word Aryavarta means the land of the Aryans. The later Vedic period is also called the epic age, as the great epics Ramayana and Mahabharata were written during this period. In early Vedic period, the society was divided into two classes, nobles and commoners. Later on, added a third class, and then it ended into four-fold system of social classification based on occupation: the Brahmins, Kshatriyas, the Vaishyas, and the Shudras. The four-fold social classification was no more flexible in later Vedic period. The four main social classes or Varnas were now treated as rigid castes. One could not change one's caste by changing the occupation, as the caste was decided by one's birth. Early Vedic period, the joint family was the basic unit of the Aryan society. Several joint families combined to form a village. The eldest male member of a family was its head. He was called the Grihapati. All family members had to obey the decision of the Grihapati. Women were given a great respect in the society. There was no parda system. Parda is a system where women have to cover their face. The actively participation in public meeting and religious ceremonies. Women received education. The women scholars of the early Vedic ages were Lopamudra, Viswara, Ghosha, and Apala. Monogamy was prevalent in this society. Monogamy is where a man would be marrying a single woman. Women had the freedom to choose their husbands in Swayamvar. Widows were allowed to remarry. Intercaste marriages were also allowed. Child marriages did not exist in that period. Later Vedic period, this freedom given to women was declined. Now their main role was to look after their families. Though they continued to participate in religious ceremonies, they stopped going to public meetings. They were also not allowed to study Vedic literature. The women could not own property. Widow marriage was not allowed. Polygamy also started, where one man can marry many women. The life of an individual was divided into four stages or ashramas described below. Each stage lasted for 25 years. Brahmacharya, Grihastha, Vanaprastha, and the last one Sannyasa. In first stage, in Brahmacharya, it is a life of a student where he receives education. In second stage, in Grihastha, he becomes a responsible person. He marries and looks after his family. In Vanaprastha, third stage, he leaves his family and started to meditate in the forest. In fourth stage, Sannyasa, the individual turns into an ascetic by renouncing all worthy ties. He leaves all his belongings, he leaves all his important relationships. In education, the boys who belong to the three upper caste used to study at Gurukulas, which were situated in forest. Women or girls didn't had a freedom to go to Gurukula. They were taught philosophy, logic, religion, grammar, astronomy, medicine, ethics, arithmetic, Dhanuveda, or war tactics was taught to prince. Gurukula, such as cleaning, working in the fields, bringing water from the well, and gathering wood. The student did not have to pay any school fee. They often gave a voluntary gift called Guru Dakshina to their guru at the end of their studies. The Aryans had food like barley, rice, wheat, milk, fruits, vegetables, and meat. They also liked honey or madhu and ate meat occasionally. They used to make intoxicating drinks called soma and sura from the soma plant for offering to the god. The Aryans consumed these drinks only on festive and religious occasion. For entertainment, the Aryans participated in chariot racing and hunting. They also played dice games. Music and dance were among their favorite pastime. They played instruments like the veena and the flute. The Aryan wore dress made up of cotton and wool. In early Vedic period, Aryans depended on hunting and animal rearing for their livelihood. They also started doing agriculture using wooden plows. In early Vedic period, they reared animals, and in later Vedic period, they started to use iron plows replacing wooden plows. That's all for today's class. Thank you and have a very good day, children. We'll meet in next class.